Hi everyone, it's Gus from Pi My Life Up, and today I will be going through the steps of setting up Cockpit on the Raspberry Pi. Cockpit is a web-based tool for managing devices such as a Raspberry Pi without needing to connect using SSH or physically interacting with the device. This tool is designed to be easy for anyone to use, making it a great solution for remotely managing your Raspberry Pis. You can use it to configure your firewall, download and run containers, upgrade packages, and even use it to track the performance of your system. A system management tool like Cockpit will work best if you have a static IP address set up on your Raspberry Pi. If you are using a dynamic IP address, you may have to work out your IP address every time you want to access the web panel. I will link a tutorial in the description below on how to set up a static IP address on your Raspberry Pi. Now head over to your Raspberry Pi. Now either open the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH to it. Before we get started, let's update the package list by entering sudo apt update. Now let's update all the out of date packages by entering sudo apt upgrade hyphen y. While we can install Cockpit from the official Raspberry Pi repository, we will choose to use the Backports repository instead. This repository includes newer versions of software, such as Cockpit, that have been ported for your current operating system. Running the latest version of Cockpit means you'll get access to all the newer features and improvements. To add this repository, we must first populate the terminal with a few extra variables. The one we are after in particular is the version underscore codename variable. You can populate the current terminal session with this information by entering dot space slash etc slash os hyphen release. Now to add the backports repository, simply run the following command: echo space double quotes deb space http colon slash slash deb dot debian dot org slash Debian space dollar sign curly bracket, then all in uppercase version underscore codename curly bracket hyphen backports space main double quotes space vertical bar space sudo space t space slash etc slash apt slash sources dot list dot d slash backports dot list. Since we are adding a new repository, we must update the package list, so enter sudo apt update. With the new repository successfully added, we can now install the Cockpit software. You can do this by entering sudo space apt space install space hyphen t space dollar sign curly bracket all in uppercase version underscore codename curly bracket hyphen backports space Cockpit. We must use the T option to tell the apt package manager to download Cockpit from the Backports repository. Once it is finished installing, it will now be running on the Raspberry Pi. To access it, we must first get the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. You can do this by entering hostname space hyphen capital I. Your IP address is the first one in the list. Now go to your web browser and enter the IP address followed by colon and the port 9090. In my case, it is 192.168.0.15:9090. Since Cockpit uses a self-signed certificate, you will see a warning about not being able to verify the certificate. You can safely ignore this warning. If you're using Chrome or Chromium, click Advanced, then click Proceed to the IP address. In my case, 192.168.0.15. You must log in using a system user to access Cockpit. For example, if you have a user called Pi and it had the password Raspberry, you can use those to log in to Cockpit. Once logged in, you should see the dashboard. The dashboard gives you a quick overview of your system, including its current usage, as well as its configuration. There is a wealth of different tools included within this interface. I recommend browsing through the different tools that you can use. Cockpit even supports a web-based terminal, so you can issue commands via the web. If you ever need to perform admin tasks, make sure you turn on administrative access before attempting a task. Otherwise, you will likely get permission errors. I recommend keeping Cockpit available on your local network. However, if you need to access it remotely, I recommend using something like Cloudflare Tunnel or Tailscale. Both of these services make connecting securely to your Raspberry Pi much easier. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial on setting up Cockpit on the Raspberry Pi. If you would like to see more, please click thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.